How's it going everyone, and welcome to another video on Lost Island. In this one, I'm going to be showing you where to find all the key dinos that you're going to need. For example, Giggers, Griffins, Amargasauruses, and a whole lot more. And with all that said, let's jump into it. So here we are with the first dino that I'm going to be showing off. This is actually the Amargasaurus, these fire-like spike things. They usually travel in packs, and I've seen these in both the snow and the desert. So yeah, here we are. 34.6, 39.6 is where I found this pack. Oh, they're going after something. Do they actually fight the mavs? I think they do. Anyhow, yeah, so this is where you're going to find these guys. As I said, you can also find them in the desert, but I haven't really found as much as in the snow. But yeah, that's where you can find them. So here we are with the new monkey dino. They usually spawn in packs, and I found this one in the redwoods. This is also known as adolescent Imian, but we also have them around like the desert and stuff. I've seen them. This one I found at 36.6, 55.0, and honestly, to put it bluntly, I found these all around the map, so you should have no trouble finding these things. So here I've actually found a Sinomacrops. This is one of the new dinos as well. I believe you tame them by feeding them chitin. No, it's gonna die! I've only just found one. It's taken me ages. But yeah, so here I am in the swamp. It's like 22.4, 41.1. Here it is on the map. Yeah, I actually found a load of them by the jungle temple as well. So if you want to go there for like an easy tame, then by all means. I think you tame these by giving them chitin, but this one is, yeah. Sarko's got the better of him. Anyway, yeah, I'm pretty sure these can spawn in the desert as well, around 80-80, though I haven't actually personally seen them. But yeah, if you can't find any in the jungle, have a look in the desert, and I'm sure you'll be able to find one. Ooh, giant beaver dam. Should have put this in my last video. Oh, nice. So moving on to like not new creatures that can be found on many other maps. The first one we're going to be tackling is the Ice Wyvern. Oh, I pooped. So you're going to go to the blue orb here. You're going to see this little lake that trails down towards this like little crevice. Here's the coordinates of it. It's 31.9, 39.3. Here it is on the map. So you go down here. You're going to see all these really cool crystals. And then you're going to see loads of Ice Wyverns around here. Yeah, there's three there. And then you're also going to see manas in here, which is actually pretty nice. So yeah, you're going to find loads of eggs. This one's a 132. Yeah, I'm pretty sure the like egg levels for this is just going to be like 190, which is the same as the other maps. But yeah, here's where you find Ice Wyverns. So here I found a mana. They actually spawn in the snow like they do on Extinction, and they also spawn on Genesis 2, I'm pretty sure. But here it is. It's actually getting attacked by some new Amargasauruses. It's at 35.2, 45.8 is where I found this one, as you can see, in the snow. But I'm pretty sure that they just spawn anywhere in the snow. I only have found like one or two so far, so they are very, very rare, but they do spawn on here. Here is a snow owl. I've actually found these right where the Amargasauruses were in the first like part of the video. So yeah, here they are. Here's the cords. 34.2, 40.2. These are actually fairly rare. I haven't seen that many of them in the snow. But yeah, they do spawn here. So here are some fire weapons. There's actually an alpha right there. Oh, it's aggroed on me now. Please don't kill me. So if you go down here, there's going to be some nests around here in these little like pockets. These are actually like poison wyvern nests, but I believe you can find fire, poison, and lightning all in the same place, similar to like Scorched Earth and Ragnarok. I've actually seen loads of alphas around here compared to like the other maps, but there is a lot of nests as well. So go ahead, try your luck. This one hasn't actually spawned a nest yet, but that is like the outline of one. So if you go here on official service, oh, there's a lightning, you will be able to find some. Ooh. That looks really cool. Forgot to add as well, here's an entrance to where I just was. Here it is on the map, and here it is on the GPS. 30.8, 65.4, and then you'll find loads of different wyverns. So while we're looking for wyverns, I might as well show you where the magmasaurs are. Here's one of the entrances to where the nests are. It's a little indent in the wall. It's at 21.7, 63.5. Here it is on the map. Here's the surroundings, and if you go in here, you'll be able to find magmasaurs and also loads of nests. Only this one actually has eggs at the moment, but I think that's only because there is like two magmasaurs. But yeah, I haven't actually been able to find ambergris so far, but I'll let you guys know as soon as I manage to find that what is up with it. And also, I don't know why more eggs aren't spawning in these nests. Maybe it's just because not many magmasaurs are present. So I've actually found two griffin spawns. One of them is over here at where I am now, which is at 27.2, 75.1 on this little island by the coast. I've actually seen two here. Here it is on the map, and you can see that there. I'm going to go to the other griffin spawn now. So here is the griffin spawn. I've actually found one, and these are on this island here at 68.3, 28.2. There we go. Might be pretty hard to find because of all the trees, but if they're on top of this mountain like this, then it should be pretty easy to spot. There's also loads of Argentavises. I would have included them in like their own like separate kind of thing, but you can always just find these on any like metal mountain and stuff, so they're really easy. No, don't really need like guidance on that, and yeah. So here I found a Quetzal. If I'm being completely honest with you, I'm pretty sure they just fly around the map and you can find them pretty much anywhere. There is actually quite a few of them. I think they all generally go to like 50-50. That's where you can mainly find them. But other than that, they're just everywhere. So here's this one. This is where I found it. It's on the same island as the griffins. 63.1, 29.0. Yeah, knock yourself out. So here I found some basilisks. I believe they actually spawn in groups of two most of the time. They spawn in the volcano, here it is on the map, and here it is on the GPS. 24.9, 66.6, 666. That's big scary. Oh, there's a Magmasaur over there. That's cool. But yeah, this is where these guys are going to spawn. You're going to want to feed them either Magmasaur eggs or Rock Drake eggs to tame them, and yeah. So this is a big one. It's the Giga, and I'm pretty sure a lot of you guys are going to be coming to this video just to see where you can find this guy. Here it is on the map, and it is at 34.7, 32. But honestly, I've found Gigas all around this like plains kind of area. Gives me a big Valguero vibes with all the Rexes and Brontos around here. But yeah, I found many Gigas just all around these plains, so give this whole plains a bit of a search, and yeah, you should have a bit of luck with finding one. I've also found another Giga spawn, and it seems to currently be just running around in a circle right now. But here it is, it's 48.2, 40. This is the second Giga spawn that I found. I can imagine that these are going to be very hard to find because they're honestly in the trees. And you might not see it until it's too late. So yeah, this is where another location where you can find these guys. So in this little field, like plains kind of thing, kind of gives me like rag Greenob vibes. You're going to find some Maywings. These are at 45.2, 77.2. Here it is on the map. And yeah, you're going to find these a lot of these things in this field. So just give this whole thing a search and you should be golden. This field is also one of the main locations that you're going to find Titanosaurs. These honestly can spawn anywhere on the map and they're really hard to miss. So if you want to find one for one reason or another, here you go. 43.7, 67.8, here it is on the map, and yeah, you should have no trouble finding these. Alright, if you want to find a rock elemental for soaking, then you go no further than the desert. Here's one that I've just found. I'm going to back away from him because he's going to come over towards me. 82.0, 84.4. I found a lot of them around the 80-80 area, but honestly, just all around these like desert kind of rocky areas, not the flat desert, but just this kind of desert, you're going to find loads of them. So here we are with a Mega Chelon. I found this one at 72.9, 62.4. Honestly, here it is on the map, but I found the... Oh, it's dead now. But I found these... They're really deep in the ocean. You have to go to these parts with like the Genesis kind of flowers in them to be able to find them. But yeah, you will find them. Yeah, as you can see, this kind of like has like the Genesis kind of style of ocean. You go down really deep, you are going to find these. They actually like to spawn in like packs, but that one's only spawned on itself by for now. But you do find them usually in packs. Forgot to mention that this is where the Mega Chelon is, 71.7, 56.4, down in this like little like kind of submerged area here. But if we go over here, I have actually found a Tussotuthis. There we go. Oh, he's aggroed on me. Is he going to grab me? I don't think he can grab me because I'm in GCM. Anyway, yeah, so this is where this guy is, 72.1, 54.4. These often go really deep as well, but I think it's going to be a similar situation to the Bassies in that you need to just search everywhere. I have actually found Alpha Tussos on this map as well, but yeah, this is where this guy is. So finally, here is a Basilosaurus. This is where I found this one, 75.4, 76.1. Here it is on the map. But to be honest with you, if you're going to want to find one of these guys, you're going to just have to search the whole ocean and you'll find one sooner or later. That's the only real way to find one because they spawn in the most random of places. And yeah, not really much else I can say. So to round it all out, here is a sheep. Now, I found this one in the desert at around 87, 85. Here it is on the map. I'm pretty sure you can find these in the snow as well, though I haven't personally found one. These are going to be really important, not to tame, but you can actually kill these and they'll give you mutton and pelt. And mutton is really useful because you can tame carnivores really quickly. So yeah, always useful to know where these guys are if you need one. So quick update, I was going to try and find some Maywings when I just found a bunch of sheep in this little field. Here it is at 48.4, 76.1, and yeah, there's a bunch here. So yeah, go here as well if you can't find any sheep. So yeah, boys, I hope you enjoyed this little video on where you're going to find most of the key dinos in this game on Lost Island. If it helped you out, please feel free to leave a like on the video and subscribe to the channel because it really does help me out in return. And yeah, not much more to say. Thank you very much for watching and I'll see you guys in the next one.